Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today we're going to talk about one of my favorite places to fish for big pre-spawn bass, so stay tuned and let's get right into it. So the pre-spawn can be a tough time of year to fish because the fish are always moving, always changing based on the water conditions, weather conditions, temperatures changing, any of that kind of stuff. But I'm going to share with you one of the secrets of pre-spawn bass fishing. One of my favorite ways to catch big fish all pre-spawn long, but especially in those colder first couple weeks of pre-spawn as those fish are still coming up out of deep water and deciding if it's time to start heading to the bank. A lot of times, once you get closer to the spawn, it's really easy to catch those fish. You know where they're at. They're all spread out up shallow and you can catch them on anything. But this time, it can be pretty tough. So I'm talking any water below 48 degrees, this is going to be the first place you want to look for on your body of water. So what is this magical place that all these fish like to be this time of year? It's going to be bluff walls or points that are steeper, kind of like a bluff point. Those are going to be the places that you want to look. So let's talk a little bit about why I want to fish these places, how I want to fish these places, and why they're so effective to catch big bass. So bluff walls are the first place that I look for big bass in the spring. And it doesn't have to be like I just fished a tournament on Raystown. Those bluff walls are 40 foot deep and you're like 5-10 feet off the bank. They're sheer cliffs straight into the water. It doesn't have to be a bluff wall like that. I've fished bluff walls on small lakes by my house here where the rest of the banks, you could be 20-30 yards off the bank and it's like 8 foot deep. It's a very slow taper. And then there'll be a couple banks on the lake where it's a little bit more rocky and it might be 12 foot deep, only 20 feet off the bank, and it's a pretty steep drop. That's what you're looking for this time of year. These are the places these fish like to be, and the reason for that is they will slide up here. On a warm day, they can slide up onto the bank and get some sunshine and warm up. And on a cold day, they can either go out and suspend just out from the bluff wall, or they can go back down and live on the bottom of the bluff there. But everything is within a very short swimming distance, so they don't have to expend a lot of energy. If they want to move up really, really quick, sun gets up, they're going right to the bank. They can get up there fast. That's why pre-spawn fishing is so difficult sometimes, because a good warm day or a warming trend can send those fish somewhere else. But if you're fishing bluff walls, oftentimes those fish won't go very far. If you're not catching them, if you were catching them deep on a swim bait, and all of a sudden it gets warm, they might have just slid up on the bank and you can catch them up there. They're in the same location, they're not gonna move yet, they're just staying nearby, and that's what makes the bluff walls so effective. Now, there's a couple other things that can make bluff walls even more effective, is if it's near a spawning pocket, so that they don't have a long way to swim whenever they decide to go up. So a couple of these places that I was looking at this weekend, you can see there's a big bluff wall and then there'll be a steep point and then it'll turn the corner right into a spawning pocket. Those fish can literally live there. And the other thing they'll do, not necessarily waiting to spawn, if bait comes by, they can either ambush the bait on the point, they can get it on the bluff wall, or a lot of times in the morning, they'll push that bait up into the pockets while it's still dark out or low light. They'll push that bait into the pockets, they'll eat, get a bunch of food, and then they'll slide right back out onto the bluff wall. And they only had to swim 300 yards to get into that pocket and start eating bait. That is what makes this so effective. The other thing that is super deadly on bluff walls, you'll notice some of these bluffs have trees laying down in the water. That is super key, especially for largemouth on bluff walls. Smallmouth, you can fish just rocky banks that are steep, and they'll relate to those rocks and hang out around those rocks. If you want to catch some largemouth or you fish a largemouth fishery, oftentimes look for a bluff wall that has some wood laying in the water. Those wood, when they break off and fall into the water, it'll drop down into like 20 foot down there and lay the whole way down the bank. A couple other baits are more effective there, which we'll talk about in a second, but what those largemouth will do is they'll hang around that tree. And like I said, they'll hang off on the deep end when it's cold. When it gets sunny, they'll either slide up and get shallower underneath the tree, or they use it for shade. So oftentimes, if you're fishing some cleaner water, they'll get underneath the log so that they don't have to live in that beating down sun, but the log still absorbs the heat. So it's warmer for them to live next to that log rather than just scattered along the bluff. So those are the type of things I'm looking for on a bluff and what makes it so effective. So now let's talk a little bit about what kind of baits you want to fish there to make sure you have the most amount of success possible when fishing these types of areas. So my number one pick for fishing a bluff this time of year is going to be a jerkbait. Early spring, those fish are cold, and like I said, they can move up and down very quickly on those bluff walls, which is what makes a jerkbait so effective, especially if you have clear water. You can throw this jerkbait all the way up to the bank, you can sit off a decent way, not too far because they won't get too far off the bluff so they can swim up and down, but when you work your jerkbait out, you can cover the shallow part and then it'll come off the drop and keep going out a little bit deeper, and depending on where those fish are, either on the bottom out deep, up shallow, or suspended, that jerkbait will catch all three of those fish. Those fish will come up off the bottom to get that jerkbait if you fish it slow enough. They'll eat it shallow if you put it right up on the bank and they're up shallow, or if you bring it through suspended fish, you can get it out there. So as you're fishing your jerkbait, if you notice, wow, every time I get it off 30 feet from the bank, I'm getting a bite, those fish are either suspended out there or they're sitting on the bottom, and you can adjust your presentation accordingly. So that is what makes this bait so effective. You can fish it slow and it covers all the depth zones that those fish could live in on a bluff wall, and it's one of my favorite ways to catch them. I have two other baits that are super effective as well, with the first bait being a swim bait. So I use a small little swim bait. This is a Kitech 3.3, and I'll put it on either a 1/4 ounce or a 3/8 ounce jig head, depending on the depth of the bluff. You can even go with a 3/16. So if you go with a smaller size, you can fish it for suspended fish and just reel it through the water column, not hitting the bottom. Or if you notice the fish are on the bottom, you can go to a heavier weight, and what I'll do is work it down the bluff wall. Rather than throwing this swim bait out there and just slow winding it back in, I'll 45 degree angle throw it up on the bluff, I'll let it sink down to the bottom, I'll reel my swim bait just a little bit and it'll start to slowly crawl down the bluff wall, and then you'll hit one of those shelves where it drops. When it drops off that shelf, I'll open my bail or push my button on my reel, depending if I'm using a bait caster or spinning reel, and I'll let that bait fall right down that shelf. Then you'll hit the bottom there. When your line lays slack, I'll start my retrieve again and reel it really slowly. So instead of me just reeling the bait off the shelf in 8 foot and then just keeping it at 8 foot because that's where that bait's staying, I'm stair-stepping it down the bluff wall to cover all the fish that are on the bottom, any nook or cranny that's under that bluff wall there. Those fish could be hiding in, and you drop that swim bait in front of them, they'll come out and get it. It's a super effective way to catch fish on bluff walls. A variation of this that also works well because it covers all three depth zones and suspended fish is the A-rig. It's an awesome bluff wall fishing bait as well, but sometimes I like the single swim bait as well. Also, I fish bass tournaments, Bassmaster, and you're not allowed to use A-rigs, so I just use the single swim bait, and it works the same. You can fish it just the same as an A-rig, all three depth zones. That's the key, as you're noticing, with these bait selections here. And my final and probably my favorite bait to fish bluff walls with, because it works no matter how cold the water is, and it works in almost all of those depth zones. This will not catch suspended fish. If they are suspended, you'll have to go to the jerkbait, but a lot of times I'm leaving multiple baits rigged up. I'll have a jerkbait and this guy right here, especially if I'm fishing largemouth bluffs over smallmouth bluffs. And that is going to be a jig. Not saying this won't work for smallmouth either. You can put a finesse jig on with a little double tail trailer and you will absolutely catch smallmouth. But when I'm fishing those lay down pieces of wood that are in the water, this is super effective to catch cold water largemouth bass sitting on those bluffs. Especially on a sunny day, they'll tuck up under that wood and hang out there, they'll get their warmth, and they're super easy to target. You can tell every piece of wood laying down in the water, and all you have to do is throw this jig up to the base of the wood and slowly work it down the bluff wall. So you'll pull it a little bit and you'll feel it fall down, and it'll get down to the next shelf. You might pull it over a limb and then you let it fall back down to the bottom and you just work it really slowly down that bluff wall. And that presentation right there will catch some big largemouth bass no matter how cold the water is. I have fished down into 42, 45 degree water range right when the ice comes off. And if we have a couple sunny days, those fish will get on those bluffs and they'll slide up on those pieces of wood And I've caught some big bass very early on a jig just doing that on those steeper banks. And again, that doesn't mean that it has to be 20, 30 feet deep. Some of these bluff walls that I'm fishing and catching big bass in 42 degree water are only 12, 15 foot deep. And I'm just fishing it very slowly down that steep bank, and there will be some big bass on it. Deep is a relative term based on your lake, and at some lakes you don't have very deep water. Like I said, Raystown, it's almost 200 feet deep down by the dam. Deep is very, very deep there. It's 20, 30, even 40 foot, and those fish will live in that. On the lake by my house here, it doesn't get any deeper than 20 foot. So a 10 foot drop that's very close to the bank is considered a bluff wall to me. So that's what you're looking for. You're just looking for those steep looking banks. You can see how steep that bank is. You can see the rock, you can see the sheer drop off there, you can see the first little bit of ledge of shallow water, and then it kind of just drops a little bit deeper into some deeper water, and that is what you're looking for. That is the key to catching some big bass in the early spring. And if you enjoyed today's video and want to learn how to set your jig up to make sure you're catching a lot of big early spring bass on these bluff walls, go ahead and check this video out right here. And I hope you enjoyed today's video. Leave a like down below if you did, and subscribe so you don't miss any more of my fishing tips coming up.